that eat away at the human heart. And this is the reason why God gave us the comforter. Religion is not going to comfort you. Religion has no power to comfort anybody, because God has given us of his Holy Spirit. We should go for the Spirit of God. Can you imagine living your life with the Spirit of God inside of you, without any fear whatsoever, without any anxiety whatsoever, without any depression whatsoever? Do you know that you can live life, you can live a Christian life with the Spirit of God resident on the inside of you? That's God's plan for humanity. That's what God intended for you. God wants to live in your heart, and this is why the gospel of Jesus Christ is coming out to you. If you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus is the Son of God, God bless you. Amen. Thank you. If you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, immediately you also become a child of God by adoption. If you believe in your heart and confess it with your mouth that God raised Jesus from the dead, that relationship between you and God will be brought back to life. And then you have to find yourself a Bible believing church. Then you have to get yourself a copy of the Bible, read and obey. And when you get on your knees to pray, you pray in the name of Jesus. Do you know why you need to pray in the name of Jesus? Because after Jesus was risen from the dead, he was ascended into heaven. He went up into heaven. The only way you can make sure that your prayers are ascending into heaven is by praying your prayers in the name of the man who is ascended into heaven. If you're praying your prayers in the name of the man who's in the grave, guess where your prayers are going? Down into the grave. But if you pray your prayers in the name of Jesus, your prayers will ascend into heaven, just like how Jesus ascended into heaven. Pray in the name of Jesus Christ, your prayers will ascend into heaven, just like how Jesus ascended into heaven. That's how it works. That's what Jesus said. If I follow a man who lives in Morside, I'm gonna end up in Morside. If I follow a man who lives in Royton, I'm gonna end up in Royton. If I follow a man who's in the grave, that's where your prayers will end up. And if you follow a man who is in heaven, that's exactly where your prayers are going to end up. If you pray in the name of Jesus, Jesus is ascended and is exalted and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And when you pray your prayer in the name of Jesus, that's exactly where your prayers are going to end up. It makes perfect sense. If I follow you, I'm going to end up at your house. If you follow me, you're going to end up at my house. If you follow Jesus, you're going to end up in Jesus' house. And Jesus' house is in heaven. The one way that you can make sure that your prayers come before God is when you pray in the name of Jesus. There's power in that name. The name of Jesus Christ is the name that God has given under heaven for men to be saved. There is no other name given under heaven whereby men can be saved except the name of Jesus. If you are looking for a relationship with the true and the living God, if you are looking for reconciliation with God, if you are looking for the forgiveness of sin, reconciliation with God, eternal life, everlasting life is found in the name of Jesus. There is no other name that God has given whereby men can be saved. You know why the name of Jesus is so powerful? Because this is the name of a man who died and rose again. That's how powerful the name of Jesus is. They put him in the grave. He was there in the grave for 3 days. But on the third day, Jesus Christ was risen from the dead. And the moment you put your faith in the name of Jesus Christ, God also brings you back to spiritual life. Because I said it before, and let me say it again, that it's possible to be physically alive and be spiritually dead. It's possible to be alive physically, but spiritually dead. So when you put your faith in the name of Jesus, God will bring your spirit back to life. yes, we know that the physical body is alive, and yes, we know that, you know, you are alive in your soul, but what about your spirit? Are you alive in your spirit? Do you have a relationship with God through what Jesus did on the cross? Because come judgment day, that's the only one thing that's gonna matter. As you stand before God, as you stand before God, the one thing that God will ask you is this: what did you do with my son Jesus? That's the one thing that God's gonna ask you. Alright. What did you do with my son Jesus? That's the question God's gonna ask you. Before your body is even cold, before they even lower your body into the ground, your soul will appear before God. And when your soul appears before God, at that point, Jesus Christ will either claim you or reject you. You know what Jesus said? Jesus said that whosoever confess me before men, I will confess them before my Father which is in heaven. So my question to you is, have you made your public confession that Jesus is the Son of God? Have you made your public confession that Jesus Christ is the Lord? Because he said that if any man denies me before men, I will deny that man before my Father which is in heaven. And eternal matters are serious matters, because there's no repentance on the other side of the grave. Really, there's no repentance on the other side of the grave. Get right with God, you get right with God in this life. God is calling you to return to him. God is calling you to come back to him. God is calling you to come back to a relationship with him. And the relationship with God is based on what Jesus did for you. Because Jesus took the penalty for your sin. Jesus dealt with the sin problem. You see, because in the beginning, man was sent out of the presence of God because of sin, because of disobedience. That was the problem between God and man. But Jesus came, died on the cross, paid the price for your sin. So there's nothing stopping you from having a relationship with God. God is calling you to a relationship with him. He has provided the Savior, Jesus Christ. He has provided the Holy Spirit to help you on that Christian journey. There's absolutely no reason whatsoever you hold back. Jesus said, whosoever shall confess me before men, I will confess them before my Father which is in heaven. And whosoever denies me before men, I will deny them before my Father which is in heaven. And you know, another thing is that, God bless you, sir. God bless you. When you stand before God,